Okay, good morning all of you. Today's class will have a discussion on some numericals related to some induced charge in conducting shells. I think this is one part where plenty of questions are asked in mains as well as advanced, especially advanced, plenty of questions are there. We'll try to work out a few different set of problems. Already I have some around 18 numericals I discussed in regular class. Some around 6 I took back. Once again, I'll revise because they're the basic things. We also revise around altogether, if you search book, around 25 numericals are there. Just have a look on them. So you'll get a basic picture like what to do with when shell is out there, when charge is given, conductor, induced charge. So there is a very popular thing what they're asking in advance. Okay, take the question. Read the question. You should work out, usually outside there won't be any shell, no? So I just picked up a problem where outside also there'll be a shell. Draw the diagrams also. What is given? By closing the switch, the inner sphere is connected to distant conduct sphere of radius R having charge Q. The charge from that outer sphere will will flow into this one. So this is what happened. Huh? Let me take the same diagram. So what is the charge here? Let it be some. So what charge will be present? Yeah, this one. So here let it be Q1. Okay, I'll write it here, Q1. Minus Q1. No charge should be there on outer surface. Or if you want, you go for it. So Q2, let it be. So charge of shell, these two spheres should be conserved. At least try to understand diagram. I am coloring it. Charge of these two blue color conducting spheres must be conserved, no? Because they're connected by a wire. Charge should be conserved. So therefore, what was earlier charge given? Q, now Q1 plus Q2. Applying conservation of charge, first equation will be Q equal to Q1 plus Q2, equation one. Then, as they're connected by a wire, then potential of shell E, okay, this I think. No, we'll take symbols, A and B we'll take, it'll be easy for us. This is a shell A. This is a shell B. So what should be the potential of shell A and B? Should be equal. And what about Q3? The one which is earthed, potential of that should be zero. I think that we know it. And we are going to apply a Gaussian surface. Recollect all. I'm going to draw a Gaussian surface inside this one. So here, let me proceed with all the basics. We know some basics, no? Let me write here. Q1 plus Q4. Now let me consider by drawing a Gaussian surface in the material of shell C, I'll get one equation, Q1 plus Q2 equals 0. Can you recollect? Why? Because what should be the net field at point P? Should be 0. Flux should be 0. For flux to be 0, Q1 plus Q2 should be equal to 0. Somebody mute. Now again, what is the potential of shell C? VC is equal to KQ1 by 3R, KQ2 by 3R, KQ3 by 3R. Potential of shell C is rotated, so potential of this should be 0. And we know Q1 plus Q2, so therefore Q3 will be 0. Just stick on to basics, what will be the type of question? A shell which is rotated, potential of that should be 0. And the outer shell is rotated, no? So therefore, so what will be the potential of charge on outer surface? Q3 will be 0. So now what we have is Q1 plus Q2 equals 0. Q1 plus Q4 should be conserved. Q1 plus Q4 should be equal to Q, and potential of A should be equal to potential of B. What is the potential of shell A? KQ1 by R plus KQ2 by 2R. And there's no charge, Q3 is 0, so no need to write. And what is the potential of shell B? KQ4 by R. So Q1, Q2 by 2 equal to Q4. So Q2 equal to minus Q1. Q4 equal to Q minus Q1. Substituting that, solving this will be Q1 by 2, 3Q1 by 2 equal to Q. Or Q1 equal to how much? 2Q by 3. Find the charge that flows to the earth through the wire. So how much Q2 will be? Minus 2Q by 3. Then we know charge of a shell C is how much? Should be 0, net charge. This was a neutral, no? So now how much of charge has occurred? Minus 2Q by 3. How much of charge has flown through the wire? 2Q by 3. Okay, this should be our answer. Let me show that clearly, that hurting. So 2Q by 3 charge will flow to the earth. Some can be connected. So outer also will be like a shells, earthed. So I think we did many problems without this one. Even can be connected. Even you can connect to outer shell also. Just work out few ideas. I think there are such things not asked till now in advance, possibility of asking. Okay, one more I have. Okay, read question, this one. Little bit lengthy. Okay, we'll work out this. Similar idea, the same similar idea. little bit, I think some first before closing switch, you try to see this question. Three concentric conducting shells, A, B, C. Okay, the radius, all everything given. Yeah, let's proceed now. So before closing, so first is having net charge plus Q. Shell B is having net charge plus Q. Shell A and C are rotated. An uncharged conducting spherical shell D of radius 2A is placed large distance from T. There is a switch S connecting shell B and D. Charges on shell A and C when switch S is open. Okay, first we'll do with switch S is open. Shell B is given a charge Q. The question is like this. Now I think you know how to manage this. This is the let's not bother the shell. First we'll focus on this one. I think let me have it here. Okay, leave this part, nothing to do. What are the charges on all surfaces? So I think if you can recollect, we used to proceed like this, no? Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5. Then applying Gauss law. This will be Q1 plus Q2 equal to zero. Applying the, drawing the Gaussian surface in the material of shell B. Q1 plus Q2, 0. Then Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 equal to 0. Drawing the Gaussian surface in the material of shell B. The net field here should be 0 inside the, because net field inside the conductor due to static charge must be 0. So field is 0, net flux should be 0. Then the Gaussian surface is here. So what is the net charge enclosed? All these four charges. So with this, Q3 plus Q4 equal to 0. Then what is the charge given to the shell B? Is equal to Q, no? So Q3 plus Q2 plus Q3 should be equal to Q. Okay, no? So the charge should be conserved, the total charge, or will it go inside that one? So net charge is telling, net charge plus Q. So Q3, Q2 plus Q3 should be called Q. Now shell A and C are rotated. So we'll equate the potentials of them. Potential of shell A. What all it will come? K, Q1A, Q2 plus Q3, 2A. Q4 plus Q5, 3A. This should be equal to 0. K get cancelled. So Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 by 2. Q4 plus Q5 by 3. Now Q2 plus Q3. I'll write this equation. The charge of a shell should be conserved, no? Then potential of shell C should also be 0. Any use of this? Q2 plus Q3 will get equal to Q. Substituting this. Q1, Q2 plus Q3 should be equal to Q by 2. Q4 plus Q5 by 3. Then potential of shell C should be 0 as it is also rotated. I directly write like this. Instead of shell C is rotated. So directly with this, VC should be 0. So therefore, Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 is equal to 0. I'm taking help of this condition. That you apply here. So what is this? Everything will become 0 and VC equal to 0. why shall C dhate? So therefore, what is the conclusion? Q5 will be zero. If Q5 is zero, then we'll get relation between Q1 and Q4. There's a one thing, Q5 is zero. Yeah. What are unknown things? The unknown things are Q5, we got it. Yeah, completely you are able to see. No? Anybody value after solving?
We'll get the given option, Sandesh.
Charge on shell A and C. What is Q4 plus Q5? Should be zero, no? Because what is the net charge of the shell C? Initially, there was no charge shell C. So that also we should write. So Q4. Q4 plus Q5 is also zero. So with this, what happened? We'll get Q1 equal to value of Q1. We'll get it. Q4 plus Q5 is zero. So Q1 equal to minus Q by 2. Okay, fine. Charges on shell A and C when switch S is open. How much we are getting if you solve last equation? Minus Q by 2. Charge on shell A.
Minus Q by 4, minus 3 Q by 4 only.
Q4, Q5 are not given charges, no? Q4 plus Q5 are not given charges. Shell C is neutral.
Shell C, how it will be neutral?
Shell C is earthed.
Oh, 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 wait. It's earthed, no? Oh, I didn't check. Yeah, this will not be zero. Fine. Q5 zero, we'll get Q4. Then Q4, I can write it in terms of Q3, and Q2, Q3, I can write in terms of Q2 minus Q. Is it okay? Charge on shell A and this one. What are all the charges? We'll write all one by one. Anybody? Q1?
Minus Q by
4. Q2? Plus Q by 4. Q3 should be 3Q by 4. Q4 will be 0. Check once. Is it okay now? So this is the one set of data. If you are correct, then I'll proceed further. Huh? I think Q1 option C, we got it, everything. Yeah. No, after this.
So Q3 minus 3Q by 4, Q4 minus 5Q by 4.
Q3 plus Q4 should be 0, no?
From what I wrote is correct.
Shell C.
Okay, sir. Okay.
No, okay, ma. I just took help of this condition. Q3 plus Q4. Huh? Okay, this charges this much. Huh? Okay, now we are going to close the switch and we'll see what conditions will arise. After this distribution, now we'll close the switch. So let me have this diagram. See, whatever that, we don't have any other options to solve the problem. what we already studied for small basic, the same thing has to be applied here. Now with switch open, what are the charges? We'll have minus q by 4, 3q by 4, minus 3q by 4, and here it is 0. Okay, fine. And there's anyway neutral. I'm going to close switch. After closing switch, we'll see that one. I think I'll say goodbye to the above all things. There's a fresh problem now. We'll begin like this here. After, now I'm going to close this switch. I think looking at this diagram, we have to analyze here. What charges will come? We don't know that we have to verify after closing the switch. So the switch is closed. This was a neutral. Okay, we'll go for all the charge distribution. okay, fine. You see that we have closed the switch. After closing switch, by drawing the Gaussian surface in the material of shell B, Q1 plus Q2, 0. By drawing the Gaussian surface in the material of the shell C, Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 should be equal to 0. Okay, after this, then charge of a shell B and D should be conserved. Q2 plus Q3 plus Q6, what is the charge? Should be equal to Q only. And potential of shell A and C is equal to 0. And the potential of shell A, B is equal to shell D. So first we'll write the equations now. Potential of shell A, 0. So from that, the equation will come like this, KQ1 by A so Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 by 2, Q4 plus Q5 by 3 equal to 0. Keep this equation. No, potential of cell C should be 0. So they should be directly KQ1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 plus Q5 by 3A. As Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 is 0, so Q5 will be 0. Keep it here now. If Q5 is 0, Q4 plus Q5, it is that. Okay, need not to write that equation. Q4 plus Q5. Shell charge of that one. So now potential of shell A is equal to potential of shell D. Potential of shell B is equal to shell D, that one. So potential of shell B, K Q1 by 2A, K Q3 plus Q3 by 2A, K Q4 plus Q5 by 3A. Potential of shell D, how much it should be? K Q6 by 2A. Q1 by 2. No. So many unknowns are there. Can we solve this? You can do one thing. So we can see, like, I think we'll take help of this one. Q2 plus Q3 by 2, Q4 plus Q5 by 3. So what we can write? Okay, we'll write all the equations. 1, 2, 3, 4. Anyway, this is not needed. This is 5. Already we know value of Q5. So solving all this, we'll get the required answer. Putting 4 in 5, we'll get relation between Q6 in terms of Q1. Okay, that again, Q6 in terms of Q1, I'll substitute here. So what all? So we can substitute this here. Substituting, I'll do one thing. Put four in 5. So Q1 by 2 minus Q1 equal to Q6 by 2. So this will be so the equation 6, you write it. Yeah. So this value of Q6, I'll substitute in 3. So we'll get Q1 and Q2. We can write in terms of Q3. Q6 in terms of Q1, we'll get it. And again, Q1 in terms of Q2. Substituting 6 and 1 in 3. I'll write it here. Q2 equal to minus Q1. No? So put 6 in 1. Q6 is equal to, shall I write Q2? 7. And this is what I'm going to substitute here. Q6 equal to Q2. Q2 plus Q3 will get relationship. We need one more, no? Let me try.
After solving.
All the equations I wrote, no? One charge. One more. Q3 plus Q4 equal to 0. That we are forgetting. One more, I'll write it. from 192 it is, from 1 2. Q3 plus Q4 equal to 0. Okay, you have to solve all. So somebody, if you can solve.
Q1 minus Q by 5, Q2 Q by 5, Q3
Q. Wait. Slowly. Yeah.
Q1. Q1 minus Q by 5.
Q2.
Q2 Q by 5. Q3 3 Q by 5. Q4 minus 3 Q by 5. Q5 0, Q6 Q by 5.
Q6 will be Q by 5. This will be our final answer. Yeah. Okay, this will be our. Okay, we'll cross check. Charge flown through the switch B to D when it is closed is. We are getting Q by 5. Yeah, fine. Okay, this overall, so some possibility of asking, just I picked up. Because usually we just confine inside the shell only. It can be outside also, you can bring some ideas. This already I discussed, let me revise, some simple concepts are there. No, read the question. A conducting sphere of radius B having a spherical cavity. So we have here that remaining thing is a cavity. Okay, no. Try to focus, no. These are very popular, especially Gauss law. These are the applications of Gauss law. You look at the advanced, no, several times. Charge Q is given to conducting sphere. A charge Q naught is placed at a distance C from center O1. Or collinear. Charge distribution in the surface of cavity is uniform. Because Q is placed at the center of the cavity, so it must be uniform. I think we'll have a diagram. We have clearly. So this is the charge. It is placed at the center of the cavity. So what is the charge distribution here? Will be uniform. Let me indicate all the things. How much of this charge? Minus Q. Then it will induce charge plus Q. So outer surface, what is the charge? Will be plus Q. And Q naught is also kept plus Q naught. So it will induce charge. So what can be the minus Q naught plus Q naught will be induced. So here the charge distribution, I'll put it. You should not show it to be uniform. I think the way I'm showing the charges here, the charge distribution should be non-uniform. What is the total charge here will be again Q plus Q only. So what happened, this minus Q naught will come here, plus Q naught will be there. So therefore, because of that, charge distribution will be non-uniform. Charge distribution outer surface conducting sphere is non-uniform. Okay, fine, this is next again. On inner surface of cavity, this will be uniform. Then potential of conductor is asking potential of conductor. We'll calculate. You calculate potential at any point, either here or here, should be same. Let me take point O1. So potential at point O1 should be equal to, due to this point charge, KQ naught by C plus charge on outer surface, whether uniform or non-uniform, it should be much. What about this particular charge? So So if you draw here what happened Gaussian surface, this minus Q and plus Q will cancel, the net charge will be zero. So there won't be any potential contributed by this cavity with along with point charge at the point O1. So this will be the potential. Now this is about point. So what about potential at point A? Will be same. What about electrostatic field intensity at point O1? Should be non-zero and we cannot calculate. Any reason?
Zero. Because so when it should be zeros, acting sphere.
Net field inside the conductor. No, this is net field inside the conductor due to static charges. It must be zero, that one. And due to point charge, it will be Q naught. No, due to point charge, it will be Q naught. Due to point charge Q naught, it will be there like a EQ naught. Like this, due to this discharge, it will cancel out. Due to induced charge, it will be like this. Fine. Due to charge on a surface, in what direction the field will be? The field will be towards right. Is it okay? Due to charge on a, due to point charge Q naught will be towards left. Due to charge on surface, it will be towards right. Net field will be zero. What about this? Anyway, like this, you draw a Gaussian surface. So the net field contributed by this will be zero. This one. You can't just remember. I think better you should develop the analysis. Net field inside the conductor due to static charges must be zero. We'll finish. Let's take, and this is a very important concept. Already we have discussed. Now, once again, I am introducing it. It's there in icon. You might have not noticed, but the concept is very important. Till now, they didn't ask in advance, possibility of asking. Look at the, is asking the total electrostatic potential of the system. So here, the where is the cavity? Cavity is here, no? I can shift the cavity. That's the idea of this problem. I can shift the cavity. So I'll bring the cavity now. Exactly, I'll make it concentric. Okay, there's a radius of the cavity B and radius of this is A. There's everything. Later on, I'll shade it. Huh? This one, this, the below one, the white one is cavity and this one is like a conducting material. So we'll write it, this iron. Let's get into, is asking total electrostatic potential system. Placed at the center of the cavity. Here I'm going to place a charge. This is a point charge. So what it does, it will induce charge. See, cavity is what I shifted. Huh? And it will induce a positive charge. Now, how many surfaces are there? What is the interaction? So this is the surface one will take, this is the surface two. What is the total energy of the system? Interaction, potential energy, plus self energies. What is the interaction? There's interaction between the point charge and the surface one, minus KQ square by A. There's interaction between point charge and surface two, KQ square by B. There'll be interaction between what? Between the surface one and surface two. Minus KQ square by B. Interaction.
Minus KQ square by B, no, sir.
Okay, I'll check it. First, between these two, minus KQ square, between point charge and surface one. Okay, B. Between the point charge and the outer surface. It should be E. And this should be E. Yeah. I'll write down between let's use some symbols. Writing again take more time. Yeah, they should be between Q and 1, Q and 2, between 1 and 2. I'm putting all things clearly. Now let's go for self-energy. Self-energy of the KQ square by 2B, KQ square by 2A. This is the self-energy. Solving this, we'll get the total energy. But where was the cavity? The cavity was somewhere here, no? I shifted. So that is what? The presence of cavity in the conductor, what happened? Like a location, what happened? Wherever you want, according to your convenience, you can shift it. It will not disturb the charge on outer surface. Sir, but the way you calculate it, interaction potential, yes, in fact, it will be like this only. So here, if you calculate and use mathematics and work out, no, you'll end up with the same answer. That's why in the books, they just brought this idea. So wherever you want, you can shift cavity inside a conductor. I'm making things clear. We don't have till now any numerical in advance on this idea, and it's something very, very important. Please put effort. Cavity location of cavity can be varied inside a conductor. So the charge distribution will not change on outer surface. That's what it's telling. And if you calculate final the energy, that will also will not change. The reason for that, shall I put it simple way? You calculate energy present here. And you calculate energy present outside. Whether the cavity is here or here, it doesn't matter. No? So location can be varied inside. Location of a cavity here. Location of a cavity. I'll bring the statement here. Getting disturbed. Location of a cavity can be cavity in a conductor can be shifted as the total energy of system doesn't changes, because energy should be conserved, no? So therefore I'm making a rule. So what is the best thing is, like, you calculate the energy inside the cavity due to point charge. There'll be electric field, and also there'll be outside electric field. The field outside the field outside the sphere, what happened, depends on distribution of charge. The charge distribution outer surface is independent of the location of the cavity inside the conductor. So therefore, when I calculate energy, so I'm getting same answer. If I bring the cavity here, then also I'm getting same answer. So there's a better practice, no? Rather than taking help of integration, better shift this cavity at a convenient place and write the equations, and you'll get the same answer. And there's a very important thing. I feel you must remember such ideas. Huh? Finally, they'll help you a lot in exam. I'll read the question next part. Find the potential of shell A. Point charge Q is placed, so they're not connected. At addition 4a from common center of conducting sphere and shell. The inner sphere is then grounded. Find the potential of shell A.
Sir, potential
shall be it is. Now read the question. Any other charged object can be there outside. And now what is the only thing? Okay, we'll do one thing. Potential again, Lendi, is there in icon? I'll just find the charge, find the. Induced charge on all surfaces. I'm just interested in this aspect. And now which shell is earth it? Shell A is earth it. Potential of that shell should be zero, which is earth it. Now, what are the charges? The charges will be. There's also some good numerical. This is radius A, 2A, shell A, shell B. There's a point charge Q. This is earth it. What are the charges? We will just proceed in the similar way. Q1, Q2, Q3. This was a neutral, no? In fact, both are neutral. The charge of shell B should be net charge should be zero. Okay, I'll get into the mathematics first. So Q2 plus Q3 should be zero. Then according to Gauss law, Q1 plus Q2 should be zero. Shell A is earth it, so VA should be zero. I'll write the equation now. K Q1 by A, K Q2 by 2A, K Q3 by 2A, plus potential due to point charge, K Q by 4A. This all should be equal to zero. Even you have to take, but this is the conductor. How come these two will interact? See, when you're calculating potential due to all the objects, all the surrounding charged system, quantities, there's a charge, the potential at this point is will be due to Q1, Q2, Q3, even one which lies outside. Q2 plus Q3 should be zero. Why Q2 plus Q3? Because net charge, if you draw a Gaussian surface inside the middle of shell B, should be zero from Gauss law. The reason for this is, initially it was neutral, no? Shell B was neutral. This is due to Gauss law. Substituting this, Q1 plus 0 plus Q by 4 equal to 0. So what is Q1? Minus Q by 4. Then Q2 should be Q by 4. Q3 should be minus Q by 4. What impact will be there if I hurt the outer shell? Can we ask question? We should be ready for that also. We'll continue the problem. We'll have a small discussion on this. There's a point charge plus Q shall A, shall B. I'm going to earth it. Okay, before there's a condition. I'll keep a point charge. Okay, what this point charge will do now? It will induce charge here, no? It will induce charge. Will it induce minus Q plus Q or some minus Q dash plus Q dash? I think the query should start from there. Will it induce minus Q or plus Q or minus Q dash plus Q dash? So some charge, minus Q dash plus Q dash. I'm going to earth it. After earthing, then I'll assume Q1, Q2, Q3. Here before that, there'll be some charge will be induced. But what is the net charge? Q dash here plus Q dash, this will be minus Q dash. Don't write Q1, it'll be wrong, totally wrong. Now I'm going to earth it. After earthing, we'll see what conditions will come. Shall A, shall B. And our charge here will be Q1, Q2, Q3. Again, the idea is same. A shell Q1 plus Q2 should be zero. Fine. Shell A was not given any charge, no? It was a neutral. Both were neutral. Shells A and B are neutral. I have conditions like this. Now a point charge Q is kept, then it is earthed. Shell B is earthed. Charge of a shell A was zero. Now also it should be zero. So therefore Q1 should be zero. So if Q1 zero, then Q2 also will be zero. Therefore Q2 should be zero. Okay, let's write potential VB is equal to VB should be zero because it is earthed. Then K Q1 by 2A, K Q2 by 2A, K Q3 by 2A plus K Q by 4A. For the shell B, the charge Q will appear in fact at this one. This should be equal to this one. So Q1 plus Q2 is equal to zero. So Q3 should be equal to how much? Minus Q by 2. So better to develop the idea rather than remembering some questions. Potential due to all the charged quantities when you're coming potential, but when it comes electric field, only due to Gaussian surface. The net charge enclosed by Gaussian surface will contribute. That was the method what we used to follow here. We'll come to later on. So let's take some problems here. Read the question. If the metal, so it's telling a thick metal slab having charge plus Q, so that the distance, I'm just moving to the conducting plates concept. Let's get the diagram. So this is the initial conducting plate distance D and 2D. So switches. This is switch A. This is switch B. So they are having a charge minus Q plus Q. Okay, I think that let me get into the problem. Okay, I'm going to close the switch. Why to again redo the same thing? Let's directly get into problem. After closing switch, what charge will flow through the switches? Okay, this is a metal, strictly, and these are metal plates. So what are the charges that will be? So Q1 minus Q1, Q2 minus Q2. So there'll be electrostatic field. Only I'll draw one line. In fact, it'll be there. So this field you call E1, this E2. The separation, this is D, and this is 2D. Okay, what is a metal? Metal, any field I should show inside the metal? No, there should not be any field. Because all these Q1, Q2 are what? They are static charges. Whose help you should take that one? So let me call this as C. This anyway, they say A, no? This is a B. So VCA should be equal to VCB. Any equation can I equate like this? Because both these are rotated, no? What is the potential of A? Potential of A should be equal to potential of B. Please, you have to take help of this whenever this rotated plate comes. This thing. Any reason? Both are or say equal to zero, right? This will be much safer as both are rotated. So therefore, what you can write VCA equal to VCB. What is VCA minus E1 into D? What is VCB? E2 into 2D. Then conservation of charge. What was the charge given to the plate C? Q charge is given, so it should remain as it is. So this Q should be equal to Q2 minus Q1. What is E1? E1 should be, why negative sign? Electrostatic field is from A to C. We are writing potential difference VCA. So definitely what will happen? Negative should come here. So what is E1? E1 should be Q1 by A epsilon naught. This should be Q2 by A epsilon naught. So therefore minus Q1 equal to 2Q2. So there's equation 1 from 192, Q equal to Q2 equal to Q1 is minus 2Q2. So Q2 equal to Q by 3. How much Q1? 2Q by 3. What charge will finally flow? Is asking the charge flown through the switches. What was the earlier charge? Charge of plate B was plus Q, no? No, how much it is? Minus Q by 3. Any negative signs will come? Nothing,
huh? Q1 should be negative, sir.
Negative, huh? Yeah. Okay, now come for this. Q1 was negative. Earlier, what was the charge of plate A? Plate A was how much? Minus Q. Now it has become minus 2Q by 3. So shall I say Q by 3 charge left? This. Come for. Q2 was, it was plus Q. Now it has become minus Q by 3. So 4Q by 3 charge.
Sir, Q by 3 charge entered, no sir.
For both A and B direction.
Upward.
Initially, A is having minus Q. Afterwards, it is having minus Q by 3. So minus Q by 3 should flow towards the ground. So Q by 3 should flow to the plate.
Okay, like this much. Okay. Minus Q, no? Minus Q. Now it is how much? Minus 2 Q by 3. Let me check.
Second plate 2 Q by 3 should go upwards.
I'll do one thing. Earlier what minus Q. So some charge QA and finally it has become how much? Minus 2 Q by 3. So QA equal to Q minus 2 Q by 3. So Q by 3 charge flown. Okay, this is the thing. Okay, let's come for plate B. What was earlier charge? Plus Q. I'll assume some QB charge entered. And finally it has become minus Q by 3. So QB is equal to minus 2 Q by 3.
Initially minus Q is present.
Plate B. Plate B was
minus 4 Q by 3, sir.
Minus 4 Q by 3, sir. Not minus 2 Q by
3. Minus 4 Q by 3. So QB, how much we are getting now? Minus 4 Q by 3. So it should leave, no?
Yes, sir.
It should leave. So it should be like this. Then take help of that capacitor, no? The plate charge entered. So I think now the sign should be like this. Because I took the left, no? Negative charge, you have to put it. We do have many problems where this was neutral plate was introduced. Here what happened? A plate with a charge Q is introduced. So as this is not at a charge of this will be conserved. And carry on the problem. I think the main idea of this question is this one. As the plate NB are there, potential of that should be equal to zero, then we are using this one. This already I discussed once again. So this is about the conservation of angular momentum we are bringing. So this is positive charge fixed, a positive charge from far away. You can see this infinity projected here. What would be the minimum distance? So we know that once it, because of velocity, once they start interacting, how the electrostatic force will act in the direction. Because of force and velocity, how the path pass should be in this way. So it will deflect. So here, this will be the minimum distance. So now it will have velocity in this direction. What is an unknown thing? R minimum and V will be unknown. And at minimum distance, they should be perpendicular. Applying conservation of angular momentum. About what? About a fixed charge O. L O Z I equal to L O Z F. Initial angular momentum M V naught D. Final angular momentum M V R minimum. Next, again, interaction potential energy. So initial total mechanical energy should be conserved. So M V naught square by 2 should be equal to M V square by 2 plus K Q Q. Solving 192 will get the required answer. Again, check the advanced paper, mains paper. We don't have anything problems of like this. Possibility of asking. So just recollect. So let's take if the even discharge is also projected. I brought another condition where both the charge particles are there, separated by distance. I'll project it. So find the minimum separation between them. So how the trajectory, if they start interacting, the force on this will act here. Because of force and velocity, it will deflect like this. Similarly, the force of interaction will be in this direction will be acted. So force and there's a velocity. So now say like just stick on to the basics and don't struggle anything. If there's a velocity and force, tell me how we should move like this. If a particle is having this should be the path. Now similarly, you look at the Q1. Nothing big, just take help of the small basics. Tell me like how we should interact. Velocity and there's a force. How we should move? The path should be like this. It should deflect from velocity, no? Go back to the projectile motion. When you throw an object horizontally, due to weight and horizontal velocity, it will deflect from velocity or it will deflect through from the weight. It will deflect from the velocity vector, not from the gravitational force vector or from the weight vector. So therefore, the path of this should be, let's make small. So how the resultant path of this should be? So this is the minimum distance it will come. This will be the R minimum. So when the charge particle is here, V2. So what is the only thing alternative left over for us? Conservation of angular momentum, conservation of mechanical energy. About what point you should conserve angular momentum?
Center of mass.
About any point, shall I put? What do you say? About any point you can conserve, no? But if you conserve about center of mass, it'll be easy for you to get the answer. Able to get the conditions. If you conserve about what, like about center of mass, it'll be easy for you to write equation. You can conserve about any point here. So where the center of mass will be. So let me make M1 heavier than M2. So center of mass should lie. So here is the For understanding purpose. So this is center of mass. Will center of mass will shift? Next question. Yes, velocity of center of mass, VCM. In what direction center of mass should shift? Only along x axis, should not shift along y axis. Any reason?
Initial
velocity of center of mass. VCM, say, just bring all, just dump things, nothing. VCM bar should be equal to M1 U1 I cap, M2 U2 I cap by M1 plus M2. So definitely what happened? It is having only X component. So therefore, center of mass, in fact, will be moving, will not be attached here. So altogether, we'll make it like this. About center of mass is what? So initially also it will be, initial they'll be far away, no? So let me take like this here. And then if the total distance is D, so call this is say like a initial distance D2, this is D1. With respect to center of mass, you have to write the equation. Now, conservation of mechanical energy, conservation of angular momentum. What about the center of mass? Initially, it was here. There's about some final account to. Okay, now, what are the equations we can write? Previously, it was about fixed point. Now the point itself is moving. Shall we apply about center of mass or about any? About center of mass you should apply. So this distance, let it be say R1, R2. Let this be R1. That R1 plus R2 is what? Minimum. So conservation of mechanical energy, M1 U1 square by 2, m2 u2 square by 2 should be equal to m1 v1 square by 2 m2 v2 square by 2 plus k q1 q2 r minimum. Initially there's no interaction potential energy. Okay, this is the okay, this is V1, V2 and R minimum. Okay, this is the one thing. Next again, conservation of angular term. We should apply conservation of angular term here slightly in the C frame. If you do it, no? So calculate the velocity of particle with respect to C frame. This is a V2, V1 or what? Velocity with respect to, okay, this U1, no? This is, yeah. Now, what are U1, U2 velocities? They're with respect to ground frame. Similarly, V1, V2 are velocity with respect to ground frame. You should calculate with respect to C frame, velocity of particle. So this angle will be theta 2. I'm just giving overall general idea. Can we apply conservation of angular momentum? A conservation of linear momentum. Yes, it should be. M1 U1 minus M2 U2 should be equal to M2 V2 cos theta 2, M1 V1 cos theta 1. What should happen to the components of velocity along the line joining center of masses? Go back to the minimum. When there's minimum, what happened? The velocities along line joining, what happened? Should be equal, no? Similar to like a collision idea. I'll bring one more page. Okay, this is about the thing. So velocity along the line joining the point charges should be equal, that one. So should be equal means, so when it will be minimum? When velocity along line joining the point charges, what happened? That should be equal, no? Similar to the collision side, yeah, that one. Then again, if force will act, it will further increase. So here, I think I didn't draw the diagram properly. V1 sine theta 1 should be equal to V2 sine theta 2. Let me, trajectory will be like this only, no?
Conservation of linear momentums.
That anyway I'll apply it. But one more along line joining, I should bring one condition. Actually, at this particular point, they'll have common velocity along line joining them.
When theta 1 is equal to
theta 2. Okay, I'll write some equations. Conservation of linear momentum. This is one equation. This is another equation. And then velocity along line joining the point charges should be equal.
It's 0, no, sir. Even is perpendicular to the line joining.
Initially, how much it was? Zero, no? Momentum. No, along line joining, no? Velocity of center of mass, along line joining, along y-axis should be zero. That's what we can write it here. Not along line joining should be equal, huh? Then only minimum is possible.
Conservation of momentum along y-axis, no?
We can write theta 1 equal to
theta 2 also. Okay, this is about x-axis, no? Along x-axis, we'll write it. Yeah. along y-axis, 0 should be equal to m2 v2 sine theta 2 minus m1 v1 sine theta 1. Now we are doing totally in ground frame. Huh? This is, yeah. Center of mass position, earlier it will be m1, m1 d1 should be equal to m2 d2. Now it will be m1 r1 should be equal to m2 r2. D1 by D2 should be equal to R1 by R2. I think you see so many unknowns are there. So angular momentum we didn't brought, no, till now. No, applying angular momentum. With respect to in C frame, again, we should get velocity, sir. Very lengthy it is becoming. Velocity of particles in C frame, you have to bring it. Then applying conservation of angular momentum with respect to C frame.
Sir, we can write theta 1 equal to theta 2. We can get V1 and V2. Then we can go for...
How you equate them?
What, sir?
How you can write theta 1 equal to theta 2? Any reason?
Sir, V1 and V2 are parallel to each other because both of them are perpendicular to the common line.
Reflection will be equal, sir.
No, nothing. We can't just assume something.
It will be equal, sir.
No, sir. It will not be equal.
No, we can't. We can't. It should be proved. We can't assume anything.
Masses are not equal, sir. If masses are equal, that time we can say that.
Something. I took masses different. So what we do is we have to apply conservation of angular momentum. Now we should calculate velocity of particles with respect to center of mass. Masses are equal. Okay.
Can you mark one of these angles, sir, like the angle between the line joining them at the nearest point and the horizontal, so that I can tell how they are equal?
Which marking? This one?
The above one, sir. No, like the immediate above one, the line joining.
Horizontal.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. From this
angle geometry. The same angle on the other side for the other charge. Both will be equal.
Okay, from geometry you're telling.
Alpha plus theta 1 is pi by 2. Alpha plus theta 2 is pi.
But one more thing is like, okay, 90 degree you're telling. Alpha plus theta 1 is 90. Alpha plus theta 2 is 90.
Yes, sir. And alpha, in both the equations we have alpha. So theta 1 equal to theta 2.
Okay. From geometry you're telling. Right, minimum velocities will be perpendicular. That's a basic idea. Okay, then. Yeah, alpha plus theta 1, 90. Alpha plus theta 2, 90. So, therefore, call that one common angle theta. Then I think, okay, then we can manage here.
Then we don't need angular momentum also.
Not needed. In ground frame only, we are able to do it. Possibility of asking, just I wanted to share some idea.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, in case of masses being equal only, they'll come at 90 degrees, no, sir?
Need not. At minimum, must be 90 degrees. This is one basic condition. Okay, you better think. I just had an idea. I just shared it. Okay, we'll take one mass-based problem. Two are there. We'll wind up then. Look at this question now. It's telling semicircular ring where the point P is not on the edge center, somewhere. OP is perpendicular to AB, find electric field. Again, OP is equal to R only, is telling. P is a point in the plane of the ring at a distance R from center. I think, let me draw a circle. There's a circle. And this is, though it's a mass base, but possibility of asking. I just picked up two problems of this kind, so we'll try to work on them. So this is the So let me assume an element. So there's a point P here where we are supposed to find out there's a point P. I'll assume an element. I'm not asking field at center. Field at center, we know it. There's a charge, semicircular ring. Field at point P is what being asked. Please read the question. No, so let this angle be say theta, d theta. This is that arc. First, we'll calculate the field at dq. Let this be ds, r. This one, field at point P. Due to this, we'll calculate field at point P. Due to this arc, we'll calculate. Then we'll integrate. We'll get the required answer. So this is theta. Let this be say some alpha. I'll take it. D alpha. Angle subtended by it. Theta should be equal to 2 alpha. from geometry. So d theta equal to 2 d alpha. There's a one basic equation which it's going to help us a lot. How do it has come? Look at the geometry part. First, we'll define the field. The field here will be directed in this way. Similarly, shall we assume one more symmetric element? If you assume one more symmetric element, the net field here, if you assume two symmetric elements, and let me show in this diagram. So due to that, you can see now. So this will be dE dash net field will be towards right. You can assume two elements or one element also you can manage, but better to assume two elements. It'll be much easier. So this is a d dash. So first we'll define d dash, the distance from, let me write a. AP should be equal to 2r cos alpha. So the field strength dE dash should be equal to k dq by AP whole square. So k dq, dq should be lambda ds. This will be 2r cos alpha. K lambda ds will be r d theta. Square. 4r square cos square alpha. So k lambda, 1r gets eliminated. So d theta 4r cos square alpha. This is the dE dash. So the net field should be equal to 2 dE dash cos alpha. 2k lambda d theta 4r cos square alpha cos alpha 2k. This will be k lambda d theta by 2r cos alpha. K lambda d theta, shall I write 2 d alpha? I think problem is over. D theta will be 2 d alpha 1 by cos alpha will become secant alpha. And what limit is what you are going to take is that will determine. So two also get cancelled. So k lambda r secant alpha d alpha. Anybody limit?
0 to pi by 4.
Say when theta varies from 0 to pi by 2, alpha will vary from 0 to pi by 4. When theta equal to 0, alpha will be 0. When theta equal to pi by 2, alpha will be pi by 4. Since we assume two elements, this should be the limit. Agreed? So the limit should be not 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 4. So we'll get the net field at point P. K lambda r, log integral of secant alpha, I think log secant alpha plus tan alpha. Substitute this limit and solve it. No? We'll get the required answer. I'll write down the answer. Let me go for next one more problem of this kind. So how it will be directed along x-axis? Huh? The direction will be towards right. So something questions not at center. At center, as you know, everyone knows. So do remember this one formula. Can be tested for you in exam at point P directed horizontally so I think that this is the very important if this doesn't strikes gone I think nobody can help you you see that one. The whole problem just revolves around this one. Let me scroll to next problem. Yeah, this is the hemispherical charge at shell of charge density. Just at point P, I want the field. I'm testing your integration skills, huh? You study a lot. How to apply limits? The ability how you can apply limits is what being tested in this numerical. Now, what should be procedure now? What shall I follow? So don't do like this, huh? Sir, I'll assume here a ring. Fine. So we'll assume a ring. Then if you assume a ring, so I think sir, I'm very good in integration. Then I'll assume a ring. So you should not do here. Why you should not do? See, there's no problem with the ring. So you can find out the field at this particular point due to the ring. But when you apply limits, tell me like, what should be the one limit you have to take it? Upper and lower limit will be there, no? The point P is just above this one. So, and you are starting from here. The limits will... This is what theta and this will be d theta, no? Zero, okay, zero will be what? When the ring which is there will be due to this, the field will come. But you can't write pi by 2 because the point P is here. Are you getting, no? So here you can't write 0 to pi by 2. Pi by 2 you can't write, some angle is there, we don't know that. Because the point P is here. If it were somewhere here, okay, other thing. Just I'm asking at the apex of this particular thing. What is the field strength at this point? Just above the apex of hemispherical shell. So the upper limit is a problem. There's nothing wrong. You can assume elemental ring and integrate. 0 to upper limit you can't define. I think that's what happens when you do integration. No? The limits what happen has to be taken care properly. You cannot define wherever you want. So tell me, like, what is the only alternative left over? So some method has to be brought. So this will be the wrong idea. So in the sense, mathematically, limits cannot be defined. Limits. So don't say wrong. Some constraint, mathematical constraint, that's all. So keeping this in mind, what I do is like, I will, shall we find out due to hemispherical shell, due to conducting shell, one full shell. Conducting, I should use charged. Let me write here, conducting. After this, there's a conducting, I brought it. Somebody is asking, sir, conducting or non-conducting. I made it clear, it's a conducting. Let's get in. So now this is ruled out. So what I do is like, I will just assume this to be of, I'll take the superposition, then I'll proceed here. So here, first due to full, this should be equal to due to full sphere. Due to full shell. In that, if I subtract okay, if I subtract the field, so there's a radius r. There's also radius r. Let's come for this one. I'll make the diagram complete. So these are the point P. So what is our answer? So now there's a point P, no? The point P is here. Now due to this shell, there's a thin conducting shell. And what is this? Thin hemispherical shell. Conducting shell. Do we know the field at this particular point? So I'll call this is E1. And I'll call this is E2. And this field is E. So what is E? E1 minus E2. Can we know? Do we know E1? Yes. E1, we are very sure. Somehow what happened? We should calculate E2. Getting the idea? This one. So E1 minus E2. So what is our entire discussion now? E1 minus E2. And we are very sure about E1. What is E1? Q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. So it should be sigma by epsilon naught directly. E1 is how much? Sigma by epsilon naught. E2 has to be calculated. How to calculate E2? So now you bring the concept of the, here you assume a thin ring. First, you calculate the field at point P due to that thin ring, then integrate and calculate the field that you substitute here, and you'll get the answer. But you should not do, you should not work out this one. This is not possible. I'm telling you will not get answer. Because limits are unable to define, no? So let's come to the this diagram. Please work out here. Okay, let's take the diagram. We'll integrate, we'll calculate E2, that will substitute. Sigma by epsilon naught, okay. What is the charge on Q charge? Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R square, no? The field on the surface. 4 pi R square is what? Area, charge by area will be surface charge density. Sigma by epsilon naught will come. Shall I scroll down? So we'll work out mathematics there. Let me take this diagram here. Okay, now getting the same similarly what we did for semicircular rhino, the similar ideas is what you have to bring it here. Let me assume a ring.
Sir. The first case, why the limits are not defined, sir? They are defined now?
Not defined. You know integration very well. You can't define the limit at P, no?
We can write from pi by 4
right,
pi by
here, in terms of angle from center.
No. Not possible. I think you should correct your mathematics. So again, we'll proceed in a similar way. We should not define the limit of that kind, no? I think, so you can't say, like, okay, see. So what you want to do? Okay, you do one thing. Sir, I'll find out the field at point O, but I want at point P, no? Okay, directly I'm assuming ring. Okay, there's a point P. Zero, okay. What about this? You can't write, what is the limit here? Are you right?
You can write in terms of angle at the center, no?
Nothing, for like, I don't know what mathematics you are using. I think you look at the integration basics when you are defining limits, how it has to be defined. Okay, this is the y and this total distance is x. PC I'll call x. So many symbols. Now I think we are, so there's a charge on this, let it be dq. First we'll define the dq, sigma 2 pi y r d theta. So this is r theta, this will be d theta. So dq, we know it. So then, so what is it? dE? dE should be equal to, what is the formula? K dq x by y square plus x square to the power of 3 by 2. Will I agree this? There's a ring, no? Sine theta. So let's take the mathematics. Sine theta equal to y by x. So what all y is there? I'll write x sine theta. Or y square plus r square is what r, no? what all I can eliminate. Let me try for eliminate many things. Let me substitute first. We'll see. Sigma 2 pi y r d theta x. Many unknowns are there. We have to only theta, in terms of theta, it should be brought the final equation. First, we'll replace y. Y equal to r sine theta. 2 pi sigma k, I'll keep it as it is. So y is equal to x sine theta. Sine theta equal to y by r, sorry. Y equal to r sine theta 1. Y eliminated, r is there, d theta. X, what we can write? Cos theta equal to x by r. X equal to r cos theta. Then this will become y square plus x square will be r square to the power of 3 by 2. 2 pi sigma k r square d theta sine theta cos theta. This will be r. R cube, and this is R cube. So this will be sine 2 theta d theta. Yes, yeah, finally we arrived. And what should be the limit?
0 to pi by 4.
Anybody give answer, final answer? This is what we should say, E2, no? This is, sorry, E2.
Pi sigma k by 2. By 2, sir.
Let's get into our problem. We have to write here that formula, no? K is 4 pi epsilon naught. How much E2 will be? Pi by 8 epsilon naught. So what is the total E? E1 minus E2. Sigma by epsilon naught. Seven sigma by 8 epsilon naught. Okay, some math-based questions, you be careful. This can be asked for gravitation also. I think if you are very intelligent, what you should do here is the same question, instead of charge, if it brings mass. Look at one solve. If it brings for mass, sigma will be as it is. 1 by g will come. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Instead of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, capital G will come. Seven pi sigma g by two will be there for gravitation. What you do here should be applicable for other one. Okay, we'll wind up the class. Please do revise all things. Some problems are there. I'll write answer and leave it. If you are interested, you can work out on them. Two more problems were there. Those who are other things, please stay. Those who are absent is no. I just wanted to talk. Others you can leave the classroom.
Sir.
Yeah.
Can you show that center of mass question? Where initial center of mass situated, sir?
What you are saying?
Initially, where is center of mass situated, sir? Here.
Initially, somewhere here. Center of mass will shift only along x, but it should be on the blue color line only. Just for our along y-axis, we wrote that one m1 d1 equal to m2 d2. Initially, they're separated by infinity, no?
Okay, sir.
along y-axis, we can write one equation, d1 by d2 like that.
Huh? Okay, sir.
Those who were absent, please stay.
Huh? Sir, once can open sixth question.
What do you mean by sixth year?
Scroll up, sir.
This one,
No, sir.
This one?
Sir, metal plate.
This one,
Yes, sir. Sir, in the formula, E equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught, no, sir. E equal to.
Oh,
right side.
Are you go back to the, it's like a two plates, no? This is one plate, this is one plate. Effect will be sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Only due to plate A will be sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Due to these two, capacitor, go back to capacitor, all good.
Okay, sir.
Go to the last problem.
Yes.
Why can't I do integration with that first diagram, sir?
Okay, you do it, but you check the answer. No book has given that answer. What you get?
I'm getting different answers. So I'm asking.
It's wrong, that one. The limit should not be, you can't define the limit at this point. I'm using word define. I think you should understand. You can't define limit here. If it were here, you can define limit. You can't define the limit. What is the limit you put it here? Because here, this particular structure also will contribute field, no? And how you define limit there? We never did like that. Huh? You check it. We did so many problems, but we never failed condition of like this. So you can't define the limit here. There's no problem if the ring is here, but the ring radius will decrease, no? So it will come here. So what limit you define here? Tell me, like, which mathematics you are going to bring here?
Sir?
From pi by 2, sir.
No, you see, like, there is some finite element is there, no? There is some finite element is there, so you can't define that limit, no, here. Point P is just above. I think you should be able to understand. Here also some element will come. So you are leaving that element. Others, please quit. Well, only those absent is please stay here. Huh?
Sir?
Okay, fine. No problem.
Sir?
Can
you open the previous question, sir? Which opened metal plate some. Previous of that, sir. Previous of this. Back.
This one,
Sir, why can't we say directly we can plus Q charge will be induced on plate B, sir?
You can't bring your own rule, no? There is some basics which you have to follow. Why this random thinking suddenly? There's some certain way of getting into the problems, no? And randomly, whatever you want, you think and you want to be justified.
Okay, sir.
There should be certain rules, no? That rules, what happened, you can't follow. So we can't, science is not like whatever you think that you have to come out of that one. Others, please quit. Only absentees, please do stay. Absentees only do stay. Okay, thank you, all of you. Absentees, please do stay. Huh?